Huawei P20 Lite, the cheaper version of Huawei P20 Pro, comes with great specs and compact design. But is it worth ₹20,000? Let's find out.
What is up guys, I'm Abhishek from Mobizium and this is the review of Huawei P20 Lite. But before we start, make sure to subscribe to Mobizium and hit the bell icon.
The first thing you will notice about P20 Lite is how closely it resembles the iPhone X design, which is not a bad thing. It has an edge-to-edge design just like the latest iPhone flagship, with a notch but a smaller one. Huawei has managed to pack all the essential sensors in such a compact space, giving the phone a cleaner look. Turning to the back, where this phone separates itself from other mid-range devices. It has all glass premium design with horizontal branding and some text lining up with flash and dual cameras. There are no visible antenna lines. The fingerprint is located here at the back, which works as fast as any other phone in this price bracket. And if I had to pick a phone in today's world, I would any day go with a phone with good aesthetic and build quality. And Huawei doesn't disappoint with their P20 Lite. The phone doesn't feel slippery, like one would think with a complete glass design. Though this glass attracts fingerprints and smudges. The phone is light, compact, and easy to wrap your hands around. The buttons on the sides are tacky and hard to press, but we cannot complain much for the price. That provides a premium glass design. At the left, you get hybrid dual SIM tray, so you have to choose between micro SD card and a second SIM card. It's 2018 and I'm glad we don't have to compromise on headphone jack. On the plus side, we also get the very 2018 USB Type-C port with fast charging support. We will get back to the battery life, but let's first talk about this glorious Full HD Plus 19:9 screen. The combination of small screen with more pixel can never go wrong. And this is what we get in P20 Lite. The colors on the screen are very vibrant and sharp. For a moment, one would confuse it with Samsung's AMOLED screen. By default, you will get a cool tinge on the screen, but you can tweak it in the setting to suit your preference. The plus in the Full HD resolution is for the extra pixel to which make the screen taller. There is also an option to change the color from warm to cold and from HD Plus to Full HD Plus resolution. The corner on the screen is awfully rounded, which can cause some trouble when viewing a full screen picture. Poor software is to blame for that. And the ambient light sensor adjusts the screen brightness perfectly, so you will not face any issue while reading anything under the sun. The bezels are in inconsistent proportion. Some bezels on the top, minimum bezels on the side, and thick bezels at the bottom. And just like the other manufacturers, Huawei has also provided a setting where you can hide this notch if you are not a fan in exchange for some screen real estate. The phone comes with all the essential sensors and surprisingly with FM radio too. You know, if you are into Saturday night DJ hits. Speaking of music, the loudspeaker will not impress you much. It's not loud enough and the lows are absent on max volume. But on the contrary, the sound in earphones is amazing. Huawei is using an audio component to produce rich sound. And we cannot fully appreciate how good the Huawei's Houston sound is. With just a regular pair of earphones, the sound output was improved drastically. The 3D audio works flawlessly and you don't have to struggle to notice the difference. The result will be in front of you, I mean inside your ear. And to know the 3D audio effect, you have to try it by yourself. Enough of sound. Now let's talk about the software experience and performance. The software, well, it's not stockish good, but the EMUI does provide a lot of features, including face unlock, quick calling, and many more, which if you are interested, we did a separate video. I will leave the link in the description below. The performance is not the forte of this phone, so don't expect much, but it won't disappoint you either. App switching and opening is fast. Unlocking with fingerprint takes a fraction of a second. The same cannot be said for the face unlock, as in my experience, it didn't impress me a lot. Face unlock took nearly a full second and most of the time it didn't work. The case was even worse in direct sunlight and low lighting conditions. The most disappointing thing about this phone is its processor. The phone comes with Kirin 659, which is the same processor used in Honor 9 Lite and Honor 7X, which are Honor's low budget smartphones. So if we get Kirin 659 at the price of ₹20,000, then I don't think that is a really great deal, Huawei. Though it works well in our daily usage. Gaming performance on this device is quite good. There were no any lags I faced while playing Asphalt 8. And the phone doesn't get much warm while playing games. But still, there are many processors out there which are much better than 659. We will surely do the gaming test of P20 Lite and see how 659 performs. So coming to the USP of this phone, the 24 megapixel selfie camera. Yes, you heard that right, 24 megapixel on front camera. The front camera supports portrait mode and beauty mode, which can capture really good selfies at times. And other times, it just captures selfies like water paint portrait. Without beauty mode, the pictures come out sharp with enough details. The portrait mode is also a hit and miss. The edge detection on object works perfectly well, but on something as complex as human face, it doesn't work as expected. But I think this can be improved in future software updates. The low light selfies were not that great, and for some obvious reason, portrait mode doesn't work in low light. The default camera app comes with a lot of mode and features. It has a Snapchat-like AR filters, which is nice addition, but I don't find myself using it much. There is no 2x optic zoom or wide angle photos, but you do get a wide aperture, which also captures photos like portrait mode. There is a dual camera setup at the back with 16 megapixel f2.2 aperture and 2 megapixel of depth sensor with LED flash. And if you are expecting the image quality to be similar to P20 Pro, then that is so not the case here. Yeah, pictures are quite sharp and hold the detailing. The color accuracy is great and it has a good dynamic range. The portrait mode works well but not better than other phones in this price segment. The edge detection is average and could have been better. Low light images are not that great. There is noise in the image and pictures are slightly over sharpened. Coming to the video recording, max resolution in P20 Lite is 1080p at 30fps. And it is sharp with good dynamic range and decent color, but you will not get any stabilization, so the camera is not going to help you with shaky videos. We will do the detailed camera review soon. So overall, camera quality is fine, but still, there are much better cameras out there in the same price range. P20 Lite comes with 3000mAh battery with a USB Type-C port. It comes with 9V 2A charger and there is no any support for quick charging. It has a battery life of 8 to 10 hours with moderate usage, which is not that great. After heavy usage, like I was testing camera, processor and use the internet, it ended up like for just 7 to 8 hours. And charging this phone almost took 2 hours. So in battery life and charging time, P20 Lite is quite average. We will put it against its competitors and do the battery test in our next video. So at 20,000 rupees, you get a phone with great design and build quality and also an average battery life, but not so good processor and camera quality. So if you are one of those who likes attractive bezels and notch, you should totally go for this phone. But if performance is something which matters to you, then there are definitely better phones out there in the market. So that was our review of Huawei P20 Lite. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on this phone in the comment section below. Give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to Mobizium. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.